So we're gonna be checking out Bob's approach on Big River and specifically what he was doing during one of my favorite Dead shows, the Great American Music Hall, August 13th, 75. So let's get right into it. I'm gonna play along with the intro and the backing track and I'll show you what's going on and then we'll check out the rest of the tune. So this great Johnny Cash tune is in the key of A, but it's not really just A major, it's more of a blues where the chords are mostly seventh chords. You got A7, you know, it's just, you know, 1-4-5, D7, E7, with this B7 and stuff thrown in there, as we'll look at later. But right in the intro, all that's going on is just hanging on that A and playing like this. So he's playing this middle two strings, right, of the A chord. So A and C sharp, the root and the third, and then playing the minor third below that C and hammering it down. And then playing this right here, the sus, the D, the fourth. So it's really bouncing around between these three notes. Like that. And that's also kind of what Jerry's playing. Jerry's playing that, really emphasizing that. And Bob's playing like the rhythms like slightly different. You know, they're kind of weaving around each other. And occasionally Bob would be throwing in the high part of the chord, the rest of the A chord. That, you know, this is kind of around what they would call the E shape, right? So that like open E shape up here. So A in the E shape, but just playing the middle part of it and occasionally playing the high part. And that's all that's going on with the intro. And it just happens that one time in the intro, and then it busts into the tune. So let's hear what that sounds like, and I'll show you what's going on with that. So it continues on with the same chord, but now he's singing. So he's, you know, he's doing less stuff, you know, trying to keep it simple, focus on the singing. So he's playing now an A7 often, sometimes maybe just playing just an A like that, but often playing an A7 like this. So it's taking that A, right, this shape here, making it a dominant seventh chord, putting the seventh up top, but then playing this A right here. So a lot of this, as you'll see as we go through it, is gonna be just playing these three strings, the B, G, and D strings, second, third, and fourth strings. So playing the A, the major third, and the seventh. So the A, C sharp, and G. And they're just kind of playing around with that, right? And then eventually getting to a B7, all you gotta do, move it up two frets, right? So it's taking that, but doing this part right here, and then going to an E7 right here, right? So this would now be in the A shape using this caged idea. You know, this is something just so pivotal to Bob's playing. So A shape, but it's an A7 shape, but it's actually an E7 chord because here's our E, right? So going from here to here, the key part is that he's going like this. Very good voice leading, the what they call the voicings, how you're playing each chord, the exact like way the notes are laid out, right, for each one, and then voice leading, how they lead from one to the next. You know, if you look at each one, let's investigate here. You have this note, stays the same, which is great. It links those two together. This B, obviously in the B chord, and then it's the fifth of the E7, right? So you just keep it right there. And then this note, the major third of B, then goes down one fret, it becomes the flat seven of the E7, right? Then the flat seven of the B chord, A, goes down one fret and becomes the major third of the E7 chord. So one stays right there, The other two just move down one fret. So real nice and smooth voice leading. And a lot of times the best way to move chords is just do as little as possible. And that's something that Bob would do, I would say Bob does a lot of just these small little changes, you know? But it gets a big effect. So the next part is now getting to back to the A, but this time it's often more played like just a regular A chord, but played like this, which is like a power chord. There's no third in there at all. It's just something Bob would do a lot. Sorry, I keep saying would. He's still, I'm thinking of in 75, right, this version, but still does a lot. And then he moves it to here. So still no third, but moves this A to a flat 7. So A, A7, right? So we're getting now a lot of movement. So these two staying the same, but this note on top is moving. Then we're going to a D, D7. So lots of movement. So moving down, moving all the notes down. Or sorry, this one's still anchoring, but these two move down. Then the middle one moved down. So now we're going to a D. It's like this D, or you can think of it like that too. This shape, right? Then to a D7. Now this D moves down to a C, a flat 7 of D. So this section I love right here, because it gives you a lot of movement in the song. It's starting to really get going. It's kind of the theme throughout this. It's like it's hanging on here, right? And then it starts getting to go, and it's getting going, and it's got all this movement moving down there. And then we're going back up to the A, to that E7 again, and then back to the A. And then one little fill he does a lot is this. He goes like this. So it's a lot about moving these lines, whether it's a top line or the middle line, the middle voicing. And then back to the A7. And then the last little part is just the refrain, right? It's just going over A7. A7 to E7 to A7. It does that, a couple times to end the tune. And then that's it, because the main part of the tune just keeps going round and around. It's the same for the verse, the chorus, the solos, and all that stuff. Now, of course, that's not the only thing he was doing. There'd be lots of little variations and things, but I don't want to get into all the details. That's just the main kind of approach he would be doing, is focusing on these three strings and these particular kinds of voicings and the way they would link up and these little kind of like movements and things like that. But he wouldn't be as adventurous playing this tune with the Dead than he would other stuff, because he was, you know, singing, so had to focus on that. So this is a good simple way to get some of the Bob's approach. And if you want to know even more and some more in-depth stuff, I've got a Bob Weir 5-day challenge. I just made this. If you're on a computer, you can scan this QR code right here to get right to it. Or if you're already on your phone, you can check out a link in the description down below. It's a free little mini course looking at I Know You Rider, another simple tune, another simple cover they would do, but getting a whole lot more in depth. And Bob would be a lot more adventurous in that tune. So check that out. And if you want to check out another video right now, I've got one right here. You can check out Bob's approach to Dark Star, where we really take things way out there. So check that out and have fun with that. And I'll see you in another video.